Power form is a way of writing repeated multiplication in a shorthand way. Instead of writing 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4, we just write 4 to the power of 5 instead. The base is written normally. Here it's 4. It's the number that's being multiplied by itself. The power, or the index, is written small and up higher. Here it's 5. That's the number of times the base is being multiplied by itself. If we write out the full multiplication, as we have in red on the right here, that's called the extended form. And if we were to evaluate the power, we would do the multiplication. 4 times 4 is 16, times 4 is 64, times 4 is 256, times 4 is 1024. You can see these numbers get big pretty quickly. That's evaluation, calculating a numeric value for the power. Please be very careful with your language here. Say 4 to the power of 5 or 4 to the 5th power. Never say 4, 5. The 5 is separate from the 4. It's a different number, so make sure that's clear from the way you say it and think it. This is 5 to the power of 2 or 5 to the 2nd power. Never say 5, 2. Actually, you can also call this one 5 squared. We have special names for powers of 2, squared, and 3, which is cubed. You might think this doesn't really matter, but it really does. I have seen too many students thinking to themselves 5, 2, or writing the power the same size as the base, and then they get all confused and make silly mistakes, thinking it's 52 instead, or 5 times 2. Never call it 5, 2. Always write the power smaller and up higher. Most people find power form with whole numbers easy enough. But what happens if we allow integers in the base or the index? Let's think it through. First, what does it mean if the base is 0? 0 to the power of 5 means 0 times 0 times 0 times 0 times 0, 5 times. Well, it doesn't matter how many zeros I multiply together. The answer is always going to be 0. 0 to any power is just 0. Well, almost any power. Any non-zero power. But I'll come back to that. And what about a negative base? Negative 4 to the power of 3. That means negative 4 times negative 4 times negative 4. Will my answer be negative or positive? Well, negative 4 times negative 4 is positive 16, and positive 16 times negative 4 will be a negative again, negative 64. What about the next one? Negative 4 to the power of 4. Well, it's going to go on from negative 64 times negative 4 again will give me positive 256. What's going on here with the signs? Actually, it might be clearer if I use a simpler base. Have a look what happens when the base is negative 1. Negative 1 to the power of 1 is just negative 1. Negative 1 to the power of 2 is negative 1 times negative 1, which is positive 1. To the power of 3, it's negative 1. To the power of 4, it's positive 1 again. 5 is negative, 6 is positive. Can you see the pattern here? If the base is negative and the index is odd, the result is negative. There's more negative base in the expanded form than positive. But if the index is even, then every negative number in the multiplication is cancelled by another negative, and the end result is positive. Now there's something else I want to point out here. Notice how I've put brackets around the negative base in all these examples. That means the power applies to the whole base, including the negative sign. negative 1 in brackets squared means negative 1 times negative 1, which is positive 1. If I write it without the brackets, the rules of arithmetic say that the power has to happen first. Negative 1 squared, without the brackets, means the negative of 1 squared, which is negative 1 times 1, which is negative 1. Be careful how you use the language of mathematics. And be careful if you type this into your calculator too. Without the brackets, your calculator will assume you mean the second option, since it knows and follows the rules of arithmetic. And this may not always be what you want or expect. Just be careful. Okay, so 0 to any power is 0, and the sign of a power with a negative base depends on whether the index is odd or even. What about if the index is 0? 4 to the power of 0. What does that mean? 4 multiplied by itself no times. Is it 0? Good question. And what about a negative index? 4 to the power of negative 5. 4 times by itself, negative 5 times. What would be the opposite of multiplying by itself 5 times? It turns out that what happens with a zero or negative index involves fractions. Let me walk you through it. 4 to the power of 3 is 4 times 4 times 4, 3 times. 4 to the power of 2 is 4 times 4, twice. 4 to the power of 1, then, is just 4, once. Anything to the power of 1 is just itself. So what's 4 to the power of 0 going to be? I need to have 4 multiplied by itself 0 times. Well, I could multiply any of the previous 3 examples by 1 and not change anything, right? So now here, I still have the 1, but I'm not multiplying by 4 at all. I've just got 1. Anything to the power of 0 is 1. Okay, let's keep going then. What's 4 to the power of negative 1 going to mean? Well, I've been removing a multiplication by 4 each step. How can I continue to remove something that isn't there anymore? But I can keep doing the opposite of multiplication. Division. So let's now divide by 4. 1 divided by 4, which I can write as a fraction, 1 over 4. And then 4 to the power of negative 2 is going to be 1 divided by 4 divided by 4. 1 divided by 4 2 times, which I could also write as a fraction. If I were to evaluate this expanded form, I would get 1 over 16, 1 over 4 squared, and so on. 4 to the power of negative 3 is 1 divided by 4 divided by 4 divided by 4, 3 times, which is 1 over 4 cubed, and so on. Anything to the power of a negative number means 1 over the same thing with a positive power. All right, we're nearly there. What happens if we put a fraction in the base of a power? Well, what does it mean? Remember, a power just means repeated multiplication. So 2/5 to the power of 4 simply means 2/5 times 2/5 times 2/5 times 2/5, which you can then go back and solve using fraction multiplication as usual. That's not too hard after all. But now we come to some difficult questions. What about a fraction in the index? What on earth does that mean? How can I multiply 4 by itself half a time? Or 3/7 of a time? Or 6.183 times? What does that mean? The answer to that involves something called surds. The half power means the square root. But anything else is way beyond what we're doing here. I'll leave that story for another time. Also, there is an interesting question we haven't looked at regarding zero. If zero to any power is zero, and anything to the power of zero is one, what's zero to the power of zero? Is it zero or one? Believe it or not, this is yet another thing that people disagree on. In fact, most mathematicians will say it's not defined, which is a cheeky way of saying they just don't want to talk about it. Or if you like, they agree to disagree.